श्री कृष्णा, गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः First, the principle is expounded. What is the principle? The principle is, as is our vision, so is our interaction. As is our interaction, so is our experience. As is our experience, so is our life. So when we talk about life, that time it is the experiences that we are talking about. So the genesis of experience begins from the seed of what is our vision. See, to understand this point, I'll tell you an example. It happened somewhere probably in Bombay. There was a youngster going on a motorcycle. And there was one girl going ahead of him. So he thought, let me go and do eve teasing. So he went and stood in front of her. From backside, she was looking a very sweet, beautiful, lovely, perfect size girl, good figure. When he stood in front of her, it was 81 not out. The moment he saw her, he went with a view to say hi. And when he saw her, he said hi, hi. When the vision changed, that she is no more a young girl, immediately the interaction changed, is it not? In the same manner, when we take this world as real, our interactions will change. See how simple it is. The other day I gave example, when we look into the mirror, our vision is different. When the bird looks into the mirror, his vision is different. And therefore their interactions are different. So the mirror remains the same, but two persons, one is ourselves, second is the bird, because their perceptions are different, interactions are different. So all the spiritual practice is, first of all, determine what you are seeing. Is it that or something else? See? Therefore, it is necessary for all of us to understand this principle. We have to undergo change in our vision. So when we go to the ophthalmologist, he doesn't give us the vision. Vision is already there. The ability to focus as per requirement, that ability of adjusting the focal length, that is lost because of whatever reason. See? And then what he does, he gives us glasses by which the focal length adjustment is corrected. Exactly this is what the scriptures do. Scriptures give us the glasses to look at the world with a proper focal length. Then we come to know two things. Asti bhati priya nama rupa iti pancha amshakam adyatrayam brahmarupam jagadrupam tatodvayam. Asti bhati priya sachidananda is paramatma aspect of the world, and name and form is an illusory aspect of the world. So when we look at the world as the world, we will suffer. But when we look at the world as Paramatma, we will enjoy. See? So this change in our focal length so that we see the things as they are and not the things what we have decided to see. After having given this principle, nanopadhi vashadeva jati varnashramadayaha atmani aropita toye rasavarnadi bhedataha. Like the water doesn't have taste. Water is taste. Be attentive. Water is taste. Water doesn't have taste. See, without the element water, taste experience is not possible. When somebody is ill, high temperature, the tongue has become totally dried, that person doesn't get any experience of taste. He goes, I see, what is this dirty you have given me? Others are enjoying, because when the element of element water is absent, rasa is not possible. According to Vedanta or scriptures, water is not H2O. Water is rasa, the taste. Therefore, this rasa, the water, doesn't have any taste. But the same water, when it is superimposed with various tests, then as if it has gathered the taste. But in fact, it doesn't have any taste. Therefore, in the same manner, nana upadhi vashad, because of the many upadhis, many conditioning, then one undivided, absolute, homogeneous, uncreated, unmodifying, undying, unchanging reality is superimposed with the various things, such as the panchakoshas, the modification of the panchakoshas, expression of the divinity in the panchakoshas. And therefore, as if it has become many, it has not become many. Like this example should click very clearly. One man with the three conditionings of the father, husband, father, wife and a son, the same man is as if becoming three. He has not become three. So where are these three guys who are miserable? So they are non-existing and yet we take them to be real. And therefore we suffer in life. Therefore, having given this foundation, now the teacher starts. Panchi kruta mahabhuto sambhavam karma sanchitam shariram sukha dukkhanam bhoga ayutanam ucchate. Now what is the body that we talk about? One day I went to somebody's house, my friend Guptaji. My friends are always Guptaji. You know, one person asked me this question. Swamiji, Rajneesh or Osho used to talk about Mullah Nasiruddin. His all stories are Mullah Nasiruddin stories. Then Bhagwan Shankaracharya used to the word Devadatta Vishnu Datta. Devadatta was his famous word. Soyam Devadattaha. Why you bring this Guptaji? I said, they have their reasons. I have my reason. Why I bring Guptaji is because once it happened, somewhere, probably in Jhumkewali Bareli, I was there, going somewhere and had to stop. Below a tree, a tea shop, and on a bench, two persons were sitting opposite each other, like sitting on a horse, and in the center there was a chessboard. And behind these people, there are about 7-8 of them, onlookers and other person also. So one person was constantly telling the player, Guptaji, ghoda chala, Guptaji, hathi chala. Continuously giving direction. And he won. He said, hey, who was telling? He said, I was telling. But how do you know my name is Gupta? He said, for every fool I call Gupta. From that day onwards, he became my character. Guptaji is always available. And you know the best part? Sometime my host is Guptaji. So I went to Guptaji's house. And now, hey, Guptaji is there? No, Swamiji, he is not there. The maid servant knows me. I said, okay, I'll come later. No. If he is not there, how does it matter? The furniture is there, the fan is there, the TV is there, everything is there in the house. Now tell me, have I gone to see the furniture? So what is that house? House is only a place to live. Guptaji is not the house. Exactly, this is what is meant here. That shariram sukadukhanam bhoga ayatanam uchyate. Our body is just a house where we are living and where we are going through good and bad experiences. But when we take the body to be ourselves, this is the first error. This is the highest sin. Friends, please remember this most important verse from Sanat Sujatiya. This verse I like the most, extremely perfectly presented by Bhagavan Vedavyas, where he says, Anyatha santam atmanam anyatha pratipadyate kim tena nakrutam papam chorena atma apaharina. A question is raised. We are essentially divine, but we mistake ourselves to be the body or the soul. This is the highest sin. And who is the sinner? Chorena atma paharina. Thief. Because he has stolen away the atma. Now be attentive. Our body is not created by us. You may claim I am a self-made man. But your body is not created by you. Agreed. That body which is not created by us, that body which doesn't listen to us, that body I am. Can there be more sin than this? What is the theft? When somebody's property is taken away without the knowledge of that person and claim to be ours is called as a theft. But we are not thieves. We are dacoits. Who is a dacoit? He openly loots away the things with a gunpoint and takes it away. We are all claiming ourselves to be the body. Therefore, chorena atma paharina. This is the highest sin. Kim tena nakrutam papam. See, friends, because of this first sin, the whole samsara is happening. Come to recognize this basic principle. Experiences are happening through the body, but experiences do not happen to the body. See? Once I was in Bangalore, Narayan Hrudayalayam, you must have heard the name, and the all those top people are very close to me. So one day, they organize for me to see the heart operation. So I changed everything, all funny clothes. And then when I went, that body was lying down, the chest was open, and the heart was like a deflated, what do you call, tube in a football, completely flat. And the doctor was explaining me. I said, hey, come on, explain me later, finish it quickly. He said, don't worry, Swamiji, nothing will happen to him. I said, he must be suffering. He said, no, he is not suffering. He is just out of the body identification. See, the moment body identification happens, then the pain is felt by the mind and never by the body. The body is a place where experiences are happening, but experiences are not happening to the body. Get this point across. See, friends, when somebody dies, the other one who is alive, that man is not miserable, the woman is not miserable. The one who is in that body is miserable. Therefore, what is the body? Shariram sukadukhana bhoga ayatanam uchyate. It is a place, ayatanam is a place, an abode, where all the experiences are happening. And what is this body made up of? Panchikrita mahabhuta sambhavam karma sanchitam. Body is made out of the grossified five great elements, and the blueprint for that body is given by the cumulative karma in the last life by the jiva. See, slowly the teacher is bringing out. That means before the birth of this body, the jiva was already existing, and in the other body he has done something good or bad, and because of that he has designed his next life. The blueprint was given to God. According to that blueprint, the next body is created. Therefore, body cannot be me. I have to be someone other than the body. This is the first step on the spiritual path. Unless this first step is taken, you cannot proceed ahead. Now the question is, what is the meaning of taking the first step? Meaning is contemplate, reflect, think, inquire. This is the first step, not mechanically. See, if we have to come to this conclusion, we have to come to this experience that the embodied is other than the body. Keeping this as the destination, the goal, the GPS destination, thereafter, whatever you do for achieving this is spiritual practice. If this is not aimed at, and whatever you do is not a spiritual practice. See, friends, for example, you are doing yogasanas, twisting the body. Never mind, do it. But if the goal is to get rid of the body identification, then it will become spiritual practice. If not, it will become only acrobatics or the physical exercise. It is not spirituality. See, if you are getting a barley in the morning and finishing your bath and doing puja, poti, etc., if this is leading to the freedom from body identification, then you are on the right track. Keep this as the thumb rule of spiritual practice. So, shariram sukha dukkhanam bhoga ayatanam ucchate. Now, next thing, when we have to practice this, that the embodied is other than the body, then what should be the practice? If we have taken ourselves to be body because of wrong understanding, it can be corrected only by the right understanding. There is no other way. So what is the right understanding? Be attentive. I'll give one or two things. The rest of the things you discover. When I am considering myself to be body, then two things happen. I take this gross world to be real. And when I take the gross world to be real, the next thing is, I keep on accumulating the things. Sangraha buddhi, possessions, number one. Number two, when I take myself to be the body, then the secondary eyes are born, gaunatma. I am mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, in-law, outlaw. All of them are born when I take myself to be body. So if we have to practice that I cannot be the body, what should be done? Don't take any relation seriously. How simple it is? And think, second thing, don't waste your time in accumulating possessions. So what will be spiritual practice? Possessions and relations, they are not the primary aspects of our life. But if we look within, if we talk to others, what do we talk? We talk only about these two things, our possessions and our relations. Try to avoid bringing your possessions and relations in your speech and talk to others. You cannot talk. And this fool carrying the burden of possessions and relations is called as ego. A small child, 2-3 years old, he has no possessions and no relations. Therefore, no ego. Therefore, happy. And we oldies, we have got so much of possessions. See? Recently, you know, the news is coming after Jayalalitha's going. She had 10,000 saris and 5,000 shoes. Imagine when they are 2 feet, so many shoes. Had there been 4 feet, what would happen? See, how many things we keep on accumulating. And that is directly proportionate to a strong personality. Therefore, this is the meaning of rising above the body identification. Lesser the possessions, minimum the relations, you are on the right track. Now, should we give up everything? No, 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 don't give up anything. Don't be involved beyond requirement. That's it. Otherwise, the whole life is spent only in this. So, after having discovered this, now the second step. Panchapranavano buddhi dashendri samanvitam apanchikrita bhutottam sukshmangam bhoga sadhanam. So, our body is called as gross body, which can be seen, made out of the grossified 5 elements. Now the second thing. Who is experiencing? The experiencing instrument is called as mind in one word. Technically it is called as the subtle body. And in Bengal it is called as subtle body. When people in Bengal, when they talk, it's a great fun to watch them. You must be seeing these days our Mamata Amma is talking. How angrily she talks, and it is such a funny expression. One day I was coming from Guwahati to Delhi. And it was a hopping flight. Guwahati to Calcutta, Calcutta to Delhi. And I was sitting on the third row. First two rows were those days kept for the VIPs. They were not given. Now you can pay and get it. So, one young minister came. He sat, because the seats were for him. He sat, and thereafter another elderly minister came. So this young minister got up, and he said, sir, please shit. He said, no, 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 you shit. No, no, let us both shit together. And I was watching from behind and enjoying. Therefore, who is speaking? It is the subtle body, it is the mind that is undergoing all the experiences. Like in a way, I am talking to you. You are sitting here, your ears are open. Unlike the hippopotamus, you can't close your ears. They are open. But if your mind goes here and there, you can't hear what I am talking. Don't understand anything. So where all the experiences are happening is only through the agency of mind. Friends, if you are able to clearly visualize your own personality, like a doctor visualizes very clearly without the x-ray, where is the heart, where is the kidney, where are the intestines, where is the spleen. He doesn't have to think about kaha hoga yaar isme. No. Exactly the same way, a spiritual seeker should have a clear picture. The body is a house and the mind is functioning through the sense organs. So it is the mind which is experiencing and not the body, not the sense organs. And when in front of my eyes, if there are 20 people, it is not a light thing. And if there are 2000 people, it is not a burden to the eyes. Come to realize this. And when the mind is disturbed, your quality of experiences change. See? It is something like this. Suppose you are standing on a railway station and waiting for the train to come. And you have got one huge structure called as wife. always busy with the books. So the moment she is on the railway platform, she will go to the bookstall. And you are there with your luggage, 3-4 bags. And you have got 2 uncontrolled children. They are running here and there. And that time the train comes. And the train compartment numbers are never in a sequence. S1, S9, S2. And you keep on doing like this. You are already frustrated. And that time if somebody comes and asks you, what is the time? What is the time? See? Because your mind is already disturbed. With a disturbed mind, you can never have the proper experiences. See? And as a result, we don't learn. A cool, undisturbed mind alone has a capacity to learn from experiences. See, this example I told you. We were going somewhere, my friend told me, Swamiji, that taxi fellow's door is open, please tell him. So I had to listen to everybody. I am Swami for a namesake. Swami means a master. Master means what? He has to listen to everybody. So this definition I understood. So we went parallel, he windowed down the glass and he says, how you tell him? So I told him, I said, hey Mahatmaji, your door is open, close it. Mind your own business, who asked you? So when he said like this, my friend became so angry. He says, Swamiji, what he thinks of himself? I'll stop the car and teach him. I said, relax. He talked to me, not to you. You relax. Then I told him, I said, what he told is the truth. Who has asked us to involve in anybody's life? Don't get involved when you are not invited. This is the lesson he has given us. You can learn only if your mind is at peace. Otherwise, you can, I'll teach you a lesson. You don't have to teach a lesson. You have to learn a lesson. Don't have to teach a lesson. And this can happen only if your mind is at peace. Friends, therefore, what here Bhagavan Shankaracharya is telling, that understand your personality fully. Body is a place where we are living. Mind is an instrument by which we are contacting the world. And if this mind is not taken care of, we come across that experience which doesn't exist. And then we take that non-existing experience as real and suffer throughout life. Like the bird standing in front of the mirror. Anadi avidya anirvacha karano padhiruchyate upadi tritayat anyat atma anamavadharaye. Now the third body is called as karana anadi avidya karana upadhi uchyate. Now be attentive. In a school, the teacher was giving dictation to the children. Take dictation, and the student started writing, and she was moving in between the aisles. So she saw one student wrote a wrong spelling for some word. She scolded him. Who taught you wrong spelling? Child is sincere and pure and innocent. Ma'am, wrong spellings are not taught. They happen. Isn't it truth? There is no cause of ignorance. Ignorance is the cause. How simple it is. Because we do not know our essential nature, and then we imagine what I am. If a husband knows essentially he is a man, he has become a husband, keeping this in mind, if he deals with his wife, he can never be miserable. See? One day a man went home, knocked the door, and the moment the wife opened the door, he suddenly lifted her And he was going to our dining table and all that. So she said, honey, what happened today? Was Swamiji romantic or what in the satsang? No, he told, you must carry your own burden. See, friends, don't take life too seriously. It's just we all have to play our roles. The same person, when he is in front of the father, he should ask for money. Role. Children are meant to loot away father's money, isn't it? Your Supreme Court may say that the property is not inherited by the son with a law. No, it is the freedom of the father. There is no right. Exactly the same way, you have the right when you go before father, ask for money and spend that money. When you are in front of your wife, never open mouth. When she talks, you should keep quiet. When she is quiet, never talk. Life will be beautiful. See? And when you are in front of your son, pretend you are a very good person. That's all. The three roles we have to play. But if you change the role and play wrongly, then you will be in trouble. Therefore, what is the causal body? Causal body, many people have this funny notion. Swamiji, I understood everything. But this causal body, current sharira, I don't understand. You cannot understand that because there is no reason to understand. See? Why this thing happens? To get out of this causal body, I'll give you a technique. Very simple technique. My techniques are not problematic. You can try anywhere. Delete two words from your vocabulary. Two words. Why and how? Immediate question will pop up in your mind. But why? And then how? So what is our life? Only two things. We are whiling away the life by howling at the life. Then the world is like this. See, friends, the moment you establish cause and effect, you are lost. See, friends, this is the causal body. So, anidya, anadi, and since when you do not know? Since when? I never knew it. So, it has no beginning. Therefore, anadi, avidya, anirvachya, you cannot speak about it. Why you cannot speak about it? Because it doesn't exist. Then, but why we suffer? We suffer because of that. Therefore, it is and yet is it not? It is not. Therefore, it cannot be spoken of. That is called as the causal body. So, we have got the three bodies. The gross body, in Gujarati, they don't have body. Gross body, a typical Gujarati. You know, cashless society they are talking about. There is a Gujarati joke. In Gujarati, cash is pronounced as cash. So there was a picture about half a dozen baldies all around and a picture taken from above and the title was given cashless society. The cash is different from cash. But there it is the same way. Cash is called as cash. And similarly, dad is called as dead. Where is your dead? In the graveyard. Such a great fun in this world. There is nothing to become miserable. You just enjoy everything. In Tamilians, everything is a great fun. There used to be some Tamilian student and they have to, you know, in Tamil language, as you know, there is no difference. Ka, kha, ga, gha, a. Ta, tha, da, dha, na. Pa, pha, ba, bha, ma. There is no difference. There are only very few alphabets. And therefore, Mahesh, Shiva, so we used to say, Hara, Hara, Nama, Parvati, Pataye. Hara, Hara, Mahadev. In Tamil, ha is pronounced as gha. Mahesh, they don't say Maghesh. So, हर हर नमः पार्वती पते घर घर महादेव रे राम. Isn't it a fun? It's a joy. The day you discover being happy over silly things, you have realized God. Our question is different. Gupta ji, क्या हो गया? बड़े खुश नजर आ रहे. That means if he is happy, we are surprised. If he is miserable, we are not surprised. It is a standard thing. We require a reason to be happy, but we don't require a reason to be miserable. So, anadi avidya anirvachya karanupadhi uchate upadhi tritayat anyam atmanam avadharayet. Avadharayet, come to recognize that you are someone other than the three bodies. Therefore, the second step on the spiritual path is, be very attentive. Second step is, first step is freedom from body identification. Then the question comes, then who am I? See, unless I am accepting this first step, that I cannot be the body, then the question is valid, who am I? One youngster in engineering college, he asked me this question. After the lecture was over, Swamiji, who am I? So I asked him, should I tell you the truth or the bluff? He said, for a change, tell the truth. Then I told him, you are a fool of the highest order. So when I said like this thing, do you mean Bhagavan Maharshi was a fool? He used to say, who am I? Inquiry. I said, look here, he didn't ask me. Unless you accept theoretically that you are someone other than the body, then only this question is valid. Then who am I? When I accept myself to be body, this question is redundant. I know I am a man, woman, young, old, beautiful, awful. Where is the problem? When I accept theoretically at least that I am someone other than the body, then the question comes, who am I? See, unknown is indicated by X, is it not? Ex-president, ex-chief minister, ex-prime minister, unknown. If an example is given in the examination, there are three pots. In the three pots, there are 5, 10 and 15 liters of milk. First, second, third pot has respectively 2%, 3% and 5% milk fat. If you mix all the three pots together, what will be the average percentage of fat in the collective sample? This is the examination question is given. How do we start? Suppose the average fat percentage is X percent, is it not? And we submit our answer book, will we get marks? Then we have to establish the value of X. If this is understood, we are someone other than the body. Yes. What is that? In place of X, we call it as Jiva. We call it as soul. And submit our answer book. And we take then thereafter, oh, the soul enters the body, goes out of the body. See, friend, establish the value of soul. What is a Jiva? See, friends, establish the value of husband. Husband is what? Man plus the limitation of wife and the expression of the infinite man through the limitation of the wife called as the husband. Three things together makes one husband. Husband cannot be without a man, husband cannot be without a wife, husband cannot be without being miserable. Three things. Now out of these three things, which is the reality? Is the husband reality, the wife reality, or the man reality? What is the reality? If the wife goes away by God's grace, nothing happens to the man. But if the man goes away, there cannot be a husband. So what is the truth? The truth is man. Exactly the same way. The Brahman, the reality, the Bhagwan, the Paramatma, expressing through the limitations of the Panchakoshas, that limited expression of the infinite reality is called as the Jiva. So like husband is a common noun, Jiva is a common noun. It is not a vyakti, it is not the individuality. But we get carried away by this wrong understanding that there is one soul per body. Like there is one house owner per house, in the same manner, one owner for one body. If there are n number of bodies, there are n souls. See, friends, correct this understanding. When these two things are properly understood and practiced, then we are walking the spiritual path. Therefore, on the first day I told you, practicing medicine is on others. Practicing spirituality on oneself, not on others. Now, panchakoshadi yogena tattanmaya ivasthitaham shuddhatma nilavastradi yogena spatiko yatha. Now this Paramatma, this man, with the conditioning of the Panchakoshas, the wife, he becomes so much identified with that lady that he thinks that I have become husband and husbandhood is the reality and not the man. He forgets that he is basically a man and then a husband. He is a man, he became a husband. Exactly the same way, Paramatma expressing through the Panchakoshas, getting so much identified that he forgets that he is first divine and then everything else. See, friends, example is given. This identification is like what? Example is here. Niladi yogena sphatiko yatha. Like if you take a, let's take this bottle, what you are seeing, it is transparent. If it is against my clothes, ochre, so it, you will be seeing it as if it has got an ochre color. If the same bottle is back at the background, with the blue background, it will be seen as if it is blue. But it is neither ochre nor blue. It appears to be. Exactly the same way, the self appears to be a jiva, but he is not jiva. So let the appearance remain as appearance. Don't give it a reality status. But when we give a status of reality to the appearance, then we suffer. Like the bird suffers, because it gives a reality to the reflection and therefore the bird suffers. And till such time the reality is given to the reflection, whatever the bird may do, he may do yoga, he may do shirshasana, he may do pranayam, he may study Bhagavad Gita, he may keep on chanting Hari Om, Hari Om, nothing is going to help. Only the bird should know, what I am seeing is an appearance and not real. Be attentive. How do we see the things? One day I was speaking on Tripura Rahasya, and there this thought came probably. This world is nothing but imaginations, images. So my friend was driving me home back. He says, Swamiji, today you said everything is only images. I am unable to accept it. Now I am driving you and I am avoiding the traffic. Is it images? I said, first of all, stop the car, then I'll talk to you. So we stopped the car. Then I said, fortunately, you are ophthalmologist. He was ophthalmologist. I said, tell me, how do you see the things? An image is formed on the retina. That image is caught by the mind, which is bathing in the light of consciousness. Then the knowledge takes place, that of the image, and not that of the object. If the image is not allowed to be formed, for example, if the object is in utter darkness, therefore image cannot be formed of that object. So although the object is there, you cannot see it. So what we really see is only the images. See, these dangerous people, they can't see inside what is inside the mouth. So they have got a small little mirror and they see from there and they see, oh, there is a hole there. He's a holy man. See, this hole there. They don't see the hole directly. They see only the image reflection. See, friends, in the same manner, this whole world is nothing but images. If the image is not formed, the world doesn't exist. See? Once we recognize this, be attentive. Colors and forms are there or not, it makes no difference to the vision. If there are more people, there is no burden. If there are less people, there is no comfort. If there are no people, there is no loss. Vision is vision. Now, when sense organs are non-functional for whatever reason, there is no harm to the mind. Mind continues to exist. When the mind is enfolded as in deep sleep, the consciousness continues to be. Therefore, it is said, when a candle is burned, nothing is lost. There is no loss, there is no gain. See, friends, we are eternally the same. Be attentive. When the child body came, identified with the child body, lived as a baby, then child body has gone away. File an FIR. My child body was stolen away by somebody. Where it has gone? Then the teenage body came, did the gundagardi, and that also has gone. Then the middle-aged body came and started suffering silently. That has also gone. So what happened? First, with the small body identification, we became a baby. Then second body teenage identification, we became a teenager. Then middle-aged body, we became middle-aged. Old-aged body, we have become old. Come on, yaar. Tell what you are, whether you are a baby or a teenage, who are you? See, friends, the more we recognize this basic principle, samsara begins only because of identification. Body is not a problem. Identification with the body is the problem. Sense organs are not the problem. Identification with them is the problem. Mind is not the problem. Identification with the mind is the problem. There was one old man. He was a CA of Larsen & Toubro. He must be dead by now. He was very old that time, about 75, 80. And he came to USA to his daughter, who was a doctor. And she has, poor girl, showed all the doctors, all the reports were normal. And yet he was not happy. So, your doctors are useless, they are not finding out what is correct reason, all that. So, out of frustration, when everything fails, we go to anything, right from naturopathy to Babaji. So I was naturally available Babaji, two in one. So she says, Swamiji, this is what happened to my father, what should I do? I said, call me for dinner, a simple thing. So I went for dinner, finished food first. Who will take the risk afterwards? Finish food. And then I told to that old man, I said, I told everybody get out, we sat together. I said, Papaji, please tell me, when you were young, how many chapatis you used to eat? Oh God, you want to please any old man, ask him about his youth. And you don't have to listen, he will become happy. And should never listen. So he said, I was able to consume maybe a dozen chapati easily. Very good. And from your body, it looks that you are very good in health. Of course I was, you know, I used to go to the gym and I used to lift. I said, how much weight? I could lift about, you know, 80 kilos very easily. Wow, very good. Do you like sweets? Yes. How many laddus you must have eaten in one go? He said, I used to have normally 25 to 30 laddus. Very good. I said, now, how much weight you can lift? 80 kilos? No. One papad. That too. When I lift one papad, I get a dislocation. Why? Because body has become old and because of that faculties are dying. Yes. Earlier you could see what is not even there. Now you don't see even what is in front of you. Is it not? Why? Because your vision is failing. Yes. Earlier you could digest even the steel spoon. Now you cannot digest even the digestive pill. Is it not? Yes. Because the faculties are failing. Exactly the same way, memory is a faculty. With age, memory fails. There is nothing wrong with you. Something is wrong with your faculty called as memory. And this is the biggest gift God has given to us. See, those who cannot forget, they suffer in life. Learn to forget. This is the highest spiritual practice. Take money from somebody and forget. Relax. He will suffer. Achha liya tha mujhe yaad hi nahi. Relax. But we carry so much of burden on our head. See, friends, when I told him like this thing, then I could see the glow in his eyes and all that. And then I said, last thing, I am not through. You are always complaining, isn't it? You don't remember the things earlier when I was a CA. I could remember the complete spreadsheet. So much was my memory. Now I don't remember. How do you remember that you don't remember? Huh? Really? If you forget, why don't you forget that you are forgetting? That you remember. Therefore, in fact, you don't forget anything. Therefore, identification is the problem. Get identified with the body, you become man, woman, young, old. Get identified with the mind, you become happy, miserable. Get identified with the memory, you are worried or you are buried. In Bihar and UP and Bihar and Bengal, nobody is worried, you know that? Because there, wa is pronounced as ba. In Bengal, nobody is buried. Buried means worried. So, shuddhatma nilavastrena yogena spatiko yatha. वपुस्तुषादिभिः कोशैर्युक्तं युक्त्यावघाततः आत्मानमन्तरं शुद्धं विविच्यात् तण्डुलं यथा. Now what is to be done? Now we have to slowly separate the panchakoshas from us. And very steadily, like tandulam yatha, the paddy is put in the mortar and slowly it is hit with a pestle. In such a manner, slowly the husk is separated out and the rice that we eat is separated out. Exactly the same way, by proper understanding, inquiry. Can the body be me? See, in one book, Bhagavan Shankara writes, न त्वं देहो नेन्द्रियाणि न प्राणो न मनो न धी विकारित्वात् विनाशित्वात् दृश्यत्वात् च घटो यथा. लाइक ए पॉट विच इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ नॉलेज विच इज सब्जेक्ट टू मॉडिफिकेशन एंड विच इज सब्जेक्ट टू डिस्ट्रक्शन दैट पॉट यू कैनॉट बी. आर नॉट ऑल योर फैकल्टीज एवरीथिंग हैविंग द सेम क्वालिटीज? The body is an object of knowledge. The body is subject to modification. The body is subject to destruction. If the pot you cannot be, how the body you can be? And thus, vivichar, by proper inquiry and contemplation, slowly get rid of the body identification. Then you will come to know, body is not the problem. Identification with the body is the problem. There was a Mahatma, he was told by his devotee, Maharaji, that person is talking very ill about you. He said, if he's talking about me something bad, that I am the body, that I am bad, then I agree with him, because I also condemn my body. If he's talking about me something bad as the self, then myself and his self are not separate. So he has got every right to talk anything about himself. See? How you think? And if somebody says, okay, I'll teach him a lesson. Because you have taken it like this, you know. Because I don't remember anybody's name, I call the people, Mahatmaji, Bhagwan. They feel I am respecting, but it is hiding my ignorance. This is the truth. So I call them Mahatmaji. One person I called, Mahatmaji, let us go, we are getting late. Namiji, don't call me Mahatma. Where I am a Mahatma? I said, okay, you fool, let's go. So when I say you fool, let us go, he did not become angry because I called him fool. He was worried, how come Swamiji also knows? Everybody calls me fool. Don't get identified with the body. When you don't get identified with the body, means what? You are no more living as the body, but you are functioning through the body. As we use the car, we function through the car. We are not living as the car. I was in Middle East. Somebody's house I went. First time for breakfast or something, breakfast or lunch. And I asked him, I said, hey, have you recently come to this country? Swamiji, how do you know? I said, you first answer my question. Yes. I said, maybe few months, 6 months or so. Yes, we are here only for last 4 months. But how do you know? I said, because the remote control is still having the plastic around it. From that I know. When a car is new, they don't remove the plastic cover on everything, you know. It's new. See, immediately you can catch. Therefore, don't get too much involved. The body is like this, the prana are like this, the memory is like this. This happens. If you forget, very good, okay. And the best answer I have discovered in America for all the questions. There are people who are sincere, but they don't understand when to talk, what to talk. They have no bad intentions. They don't have. And then to such people, how can you deal with? Like in one place, they asked me to speak on Gita, and then one man asked me question, this funny question. How many verses are attributed to Dhritarashtra, Sanjay, Arjun and Bhagavan Krishna in Bhagavad Gita out of 700 verses? He was taking my examination. So I use this technique which I was initiated in USA. In USA, you ask any useless child, all children are useless. You ask them, class 8 or 9 student, hey, what do you want to become when you are grown up? I don't know. It is such a lovely answer. From that day onward, I took up that. So when he asked me, I did the same. I don't know. When you say, I don't know, no further question comes. Try this. Don't try to justify. I think there are, no. The unnecessary fighting, you don't have to justify anything. I don't know. And you are not required to know everything. See, how many Upanishads are there? I don't know. One person, see all these funny questions, how to handle. One child asked me this question. Swamiji, what were the names of the parents of Shravan Kumar? You know, the one who carried his parents in, you know, on his shoulder. What were the names of them? Again, I don't know. Over. You are not required to know everything. Number two, you are not required to answer every question. Have option. But we make issue out of it and suffer in life. Therefore, Atmanam Antaram Shuddham, keep at peace with yourself. We don't have to justify anything to anybody. We don't have to prove anything to anybody. Two things remember. Our whole life is a struggle. We want to prove something to somebody. Don't try to prove. Be yourself. Second thing, we try to justify. One day, one lady asked me, I was very tired, long journey and all that. After that 3 hour drive and the lecture and everything. Thereafter, I was watching one documentary. And she said, British lady. So how will you go and sleep now? You must be tired. I said, look here, mama, I am not a baby. I'll do what I want. You can go and sleep. No, Swamiji, you must be tired, therefore I am telling you. I said, no, I am not tired. He said, not that, I want to be like you. I said, you cannot be like me. Why? No beard. Longer the beard, confirm is the wisdom. Shorter the beard, doubtful is the wisdom. No beard. No, Swamiji, not like that. Please tell me. I said, Mama, your struggle is, you are always trying to prove something to somebody. Never try to prove anything to anybody in this world. You don't have to prove. I am very good. I am sincere. I am not eating this. I am not eating that. Who asked you? See. We unnecessarily bring ourselves into discussion. Observe next time. Suppose somebody is talking about some of his experience. This happens, you know, every day you can observe this. Two ladies are there. One lady is talking about her child. My son is so intelligent, you know, and he asks so many questions. Now that mother doesn't understand. If somebody asks a question, he's dumb. The one who answers the question is intelligent. But for the mother, the child is so intelligent, he asks too many questions. By the time she completes her talk, the other lady, she will cut her throat. Nothing, my son, is she starts. He has not asked. Don't bring your life into any discussions. See what a difference it makes. This is how the discussions keep on going. One person tells, you know, I was coming, one bicycle fellow came and hit one small child, and the child fell down. Now the story is over. But other person will keep quiet. Nothing. One motorcycle fellow came and dashed a bicycle fellow, and bicycle broke and he fell down. It's over. Third person. Nothing. One car came and hit a motorcycle. I saw with my own eyes. And then the motorcycle broke. Over? No, the fourth one, nothing. I saw a train came and hit a car and a car broke. Over? No, nothing. I saw aeroplane came and hit a train. Are you competing? My accident is superior than your accident. What is the need? Observe this. See, friends, when you become aware of this, you will automatically become quiet inside. But when somebody is talking on any issue, we have to bring out ours. Similar type of experience, and like a vomit, we can't hold and then we tell. I should not tell, but our neighbor's daughter-in-law is better than our daughter-in-law. Arey Maharani, when you know, you should not say, why don't you keep your mouth shut? It has to come out. Try this, observe this. So, Atmanam Antaram Shuddham Vivichar Tandulam Yatha Sada Sarvagato Pyatmana Sarvatrava Bhasate Buddha Vivava Bhase Swacheshu Pratibimbavata. Now the self that is, like take an example before you understand this verse. If you are standing in front of the wall, do we get our reflection in the wall? No. But if we stand in front of the mirror, we get the reflection. So is something wrong with our face or with the reflecting media? Reflecting media. In the same manner, Paramatma reflects only in the Vijnanamaya Kosha, the Buddhi. Paramatma is not reflected in the gross body, in the prana, in the mind, but only in the intellect. Because like the reflection is only in the mirror, not in the wall. Exactly the same way. Now when the reflection happens in the mirror, suppose the sun is reflected in the mirror, then what will happen? From the reflected sun, also there will be a beam of light coming out. But that light which is coming out of the reflected sun will be a secondary light. And that light will not be able to illuminate the sun. Suppose you take the mirror and put the light which is reflected toward the sun. Will the sun become more illumined? No. If this is clear, exactly the same way. Absolute reality, Shuddha Paramatma, Satchidananda, reflected in the mirror of intellect, that reflection also throws the light. And that reflected light is able to illuminate everything in this world except its own source. See, the reflected light from the mirror can reflect everything in the dark room, but not the sun. In the same manner, be attentive. Mind reflected through the eyes is vision. Vision can see everything. But when the same vision is applied to see the mind, it will fail. The mind can experience joy and sorrows. But if the same mind is turned towards the source, the consciousness, the mind becomes blind. See, friends. Therefore, the real spiritual practice is, first of all, rise above the worldly objects, come to the sense organs, rise above the sense organs, come to the mind, rise above the mind, come to the individual intellect, rise above the individual intellect, submit to the totality, and rise above the totality and merge in the absolute. This is the GPS path. See, indriyebhya para hyartha arthebhyascha param manah manasastu para buddhi buddher atma mahan paraha mahataha param avyaktam avyaktat purusha paraha purushanna param kinchit sa kashtha sa paragatihi. Kathopanishads give this path. As compared to the sense organs, the objects, the tanmatras, they are subtler. As compared to tanmatras, the mind is subtler. As compared to the mind, the individual intellect is subtler. As compared to individual intellect, the total intellect, Hiranyagarbha Sutratma, Brahmaji is subtle. As compared to that, the Prakriti, the Maya, that is subtle. As compared to that, Paramatma is the subtle. And beyond that, there is no subtlety possible. It is the ultimate. So this is the GPS path. We start our journey from where we are. When you punch your GPS address, there are two points, the point of origin and destination. If you say, why you worry where I have to go, you show me the path. It cannot be shown. You have to punch the destination properly. In the same manner, on the spiritual path, the destination is the non-dual absolute reality that we are. And where we are lost in this world. So from there we begin, slowly drop the world, drop the sense organs, drop the mind, and slowly come to your own self. Be attentive. Till we come over here for our lecture in this beautiful place, Integral Yoga, we have worry. We have to reach on time. We have to reach on time. And then we drive fast. After having reached here, relax. Those who are living in the absolute, they are always relaxed. They have nothing to do, nowhere to go. But before reaching this place, we are on the test. Get ready quickly. You always do late. We are getting late. Ahu, ahu. And then every time you will get the red light. See, God is also playing. And then the back seat driving. You don't know how to drive. But the moment you land here, sit down, let the Swami talk, you sleep. Because you have reached the destination. Reach the destination. Therefore, all those masters who have reached the destination of their being, they have nothing to do, nowhere to go. Even a thought will not come in your mind. I had to do this, I had to do that. Not even of goodness. It's a burden. Goodness is a worse burden. We get lost in that. And there will be, God will be sending a lot of temptations to you. In one place, in Bidar, in Karnataka, one retired Air Force officer, he said, Swami, do you see that hillock? I said, yes, I can see. That hillock is mine. I said, very good. Why don't you construct an ashram there? I said, I don't have money. I have connected. No, money I'll put. I said, then you construct, why you require me? No, ashram must have Swamiji. So that whenever we come, we can have your darshan. I said, why don't you tell in a decent way? We want an unpaid chowkidar. So that whenever we come, Swamiji there, please come. And then you go to bathroom and from there you shout, Swamiji, pani nahi hai, lota le aana. See, friends, nobody has ever asked any Mahatma to start anything. Nobody has asked. One person asked me this question, Swamiji, why didn't you start a school? I said, I don't want to start. I don't want any botheration. But why everybody started? I said, then you go to them, they will do it. When there was earthquake in Gujarat, after that, I attended that earthquake in Gujarat. Then I went to South Africa. So there is a big Gujarati community in South Africa. So they came and they said, Swamiji, we have collected huge sum for the victims in Gujarat. You please take it and give it to them or do whatever you like to do. I said, I'll give you the addresses. You send to those organizations. They will do it. No, but we want to give it to you. I said, okay, give it to me, but be really clear about it. I promise you, every pie I will eat. I won't give it to anybody. This is why I said, when you give it to me, what I should do, I will decide, not you. See? These temptations come, and then we get victimized in that. So one person say, why don't you start a school? I said, look here, don't ask me to speak. If I speak, you will not like it. He said, no, please tell. I said, are you ready? After I talk, no discussion, no argument, agreed. I said, children you produce, school I will run. Am I mad or what? You are children, you run a school. Why you ask me? See, friends, don't get involved in this world if you really mean business on the spiritual path. Take all the great masters. Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi did not start anything. Is so deep. Nothing in this world can ever attract, provided we have this line of understanding and experience. So, Dehendriya Manobuddhi Prakruti Bhyo Vilakshanam Tadvrutti Sakshinam Vidya Atmanam Rajavasada. Then, the 17th mantra, the teacher says, then who am I then here? Dehendriya Manabuddhi Prakruti Bhya Vilakshanam. That which is of the opposite nature in comparison to all the panchakoshas, the body, the sense organ, the mind, the intellect, the prakriti, etc. Opposite nature, vilakshanam. Take one small thing like body. What are the lakshana attributes of the body? The body has got a shape. Vilakshanam, the reality is without shape. Without form. So when you sit down, think of formlessness. Then the question comes, what is that which is without form? Then we come to know, the space is without any shape, without any form. Then we start playing, not doing meditation. We start playing meditation. What it is like being a space? No chitta vritti nirodha. Now work on this. What it is like being space? Space supports all the four elements, but doesn't get influenced by any one of them. So, none of the worldly objects should ever disturb us. There will be perception. But the perception will not be reacted with any projection. Then life is lived without an individual being crystallized. This experience is called as playing meditation. And because you are playing, there is neither success nor failure. Sometime it may happen, sometime it may not happen. If it doesn't happen, never mind. If it happens, so what? There will not struggle. Patanjali says, Prayatna Shaithilya, freedom from efforts. Lesser the efforts, more normal we are. Zero efforts, we are perfect. Discover this truth. This is what is mentioned here. Tadvutti Sakshiram Vidyat Atmaram Rajavatsada. So the self is like a king who is not influenced by anything, but because of him everything is existing. This is our essential nature. Continuing the thought, we'll see it tomorrow. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.